أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين لا سيما بقية الله في الأرضين. We've been studying the concept of Islam and different senses in which Islam is used in the Quran, and this is our sixth session. Tonight, inshallah, I want to reflect on the last few verses of Surah Hujurat. So, as you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in Surah Hujurat many things. One of them is about the claim of some Bedouins. They claimed that they have the quality of Iman. They have strong faith. And Allah says to the Prophet, tell them, you don't have Iman, you have Islam. Let us start with the verse 14. أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ قَالَتَ الْأَعْرَابُ آمَنَّا قُلْ لَمْ تُؤْمِنُوا وَلَكِنْ قُولُوا أَسْلَمْنَا. Arab means Bedouins. It doesn't mean Arabs. Arab is used for those Bedouins who lived outside Mecca, Medina, outside towns, and normally they didn't have that much of education. They were sometimes also, unfortunately, very harsh, very hard-hearted, and sometimes also very much insisting on their own ways of thinking. For example, Quran says al-a'rabu ashaddu kufran, or one of the things ajdaru allah ya'lamu hududa ma anzal allah. They were very insistent on kufr. They were very far from knowing and understanding the rulings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But sometimes also you could find among them people who were very candid, very simple-minded, very nice people. In any case, these people went to Rasulullah and they said, we are mu'min, amanna, qalat al-a'rab, amanna, we are mu'min. Not knowing that this is a very big claim. To say I am a mu'min is a big claim. Inshallah, we will talk about the requirements of this claim. So Allah says, قُلْ لَمْ تُؤْمِنُوا. Tell them, you don't have Iman. وَلَكِنْ قُولُوا أَسْلَمْنَا. Instead, you can say, we have embraced Islam. We have converted to Islam. We have just started practicing. But Iman comes after lots of efforts. قُلْ لَمْ تُؤْمِنُوا وَلَكِنْ قُولُوا أَسْلَمْنَا. Why? وَلَمَّا يَدْخُلِ الْإِيمَانُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ. Because Iman, faith, has not yet entered into your heart. When you verbally declare your faith, this is Islam. But Iman must settle in the heart and be exhibited in your actions and confirmed, of course, with your lips. But if you just start from here, it doesn't count. وَلَمَّا يَدْخُلَ الْإِيمَانُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ وَإِن تُطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. If now that you have Islam, you obey Allah and the Prophet. So if you have good actions, لا يلتكم من أعمالكم شيئا. Allah is not going to forget, to ignore, to underestimate, to waste any of your good actions. Nothing will be forgotten, nothing will be reduced. So you have now Islam. If you have proper actions, they will be taken into account. Inna Allah ghafurun rahim. Allah is also forgiving. So if you had bad actions in the past, they will be forgiven. And He is very kind and merciful. So what we understand from this verse is different from previous passages that we had. In the last five sessions, we always had Islam as a quality of people like Ibrahim, like Prophet Ya'qub alayhi salam. Full submission in God. That was very high position. Something that even Allah says He told Ibrahim, إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. So Islam was used for the highest level. Here Islam is used for the lowest level. So you see the difference. So to be a Muslim sometimes means someone who has declared shahadatain and you recognize him as a Muslim. But sometimes to be a Muslim means to be like Ibrahim, who dedicated his life, his death even to Allah. Inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alamin. So it's totally different to the previous passages of the Quran. Then Allah says, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. If you want to understand who is mu'min, this is the definition of mu'min. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَرْتَابُوا. Those who have faith in God and the Prophet in their heart. آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. Not only they said, they had faith in God and the Prophet. ثُمَّ لَمْ يَرْتَابُوا. This لَمْ يَرْتَابُوا shows that iman is also a quality of heart. Doubt is something which is in the heart. Certainty is also in the heart. The first iman is a matter of certainty, a matter of conviction in the heart. So they were convinced about Prophet and Allah, and later they didn't doubt, they remained persistent. ثُمَّ لَمْ يَرْتَابُوا وَجَاهَدُوا بِأَمْوَالِهِمْ وَأَنفُسِهِمْ. And that certainty then led to action. They struggle for the sake of Allah with their money and with their lives. If you are really convinced that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there and He is your Lord and Master and you have to serve Him, then you would not be hesitant to spend your money or even to give your life for His sake. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الصَّادِقُونَ. These are the people who are truthful. These are the people who can truthfully say we are mu'min. If you have just iman as a kind of declaration of shahadatain, this is not enough. You cannot truthfully say I am mu'min. The only people who can truthfully say they are mu'min are the people who have certainty in the heart and they struggle for the sake of God. Then Allah says, قُلْ أَتُعَلِّمُونَ اللَّهَ بِدِينِكُمْ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَاللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ. Tell them, are you informing Allah about your faith? There is no need to go to the Prophet and say that we are mu'min. Of course, one mistake was that you were not mu'min, you were just Muslim. The second mistake is that it seems you think the Prophet and Allah don't know. So you want to go and inform them about this. Or the third problem that comes later is that perhaps they wanted to oblige the Prophet. يَمُنُّونَ عَلَيْكَ أَنْ أَسْلَمُوا. They wanted to say, we have embraced Islam, so you must thank us. You must give us some kind of recognition. So, قُلْ أَتُعَلَّمُونَ اللَّهَ بِدِينِكُمْ. Tell them, are you teaching, informing Allah about your faith, your religion? وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَاللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ. Allah knows everything in the skies and the earth. I think when in the Quran Allah says مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ, it means everything. مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ means everything. He knows everything. He knows the material things, he knows the spiritual things, the concrete things, the abstract things, everything he knows. وَاللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٌ. He knows everything. So you cannot inform him, you cannot teach him something that he doesn't know. Then the third problem, يَمُنُّونَ عَلَيْكَ أَنْ أَسْلَمُوا. They want to oblige you, they want to ask you to thank them because they have become Muslim. As if, you know, they have done something. You know, sometimes people, for example, if they say there's salat behind of a person, they think they have had a favor on that person. Or if you are doing taqlid of a marja, they think they have done a great favor to that marja. This is not the case. If you go to a doctor and ask for prescription, you cannot say, please thank me, I have come to you. You have to thank the doctor. He is helping you, not the other way around. When people go to religion, they go to the Prophet, they benefit, they embrace Islam, they must not expect Allah and the Prophet to thank them. You have done something which is natural. You have to thank them that they have given you this opportunity, not the other way around. يَمُنُّونَ عَلَيْكَ أَنْ أَسْلَمُوا. They want to oblige you by their faith. قُلْ لَا تَمُنُّوا عَلَيَّ إِسْلَامَكُمْ. Tell them, don't oblige me, don't ask me to thank you because of your Islam. Why? For different things. Please listen very carefully. Allama Tabatabai has very good explanation here. First of all, Islam is not something important. Iman is important. Just to become a Muslim is not something great. Any person can say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, and this is just something legal. So certain rulings apply to this person. But this doesn't guarantee that he is a good person. This doesn't guarantee that he would have access to heaven. This doesn't guarantee salvation. This is something just very, very basic. Very basic. If someone is thinking of something great, that is Iman, not Islam. Look at ayah. قُلْ لَا تَمُنُّوا عَلَيَّ إِسْلَامَكُمْ بَلِ اللَّهُ يَمُنُّ عَلَيْكُمْ أَنْ هَدَاكُمْ لِلْإِيمَانِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. So if you are mu'min, that is something that we can talk about it. Of course, we will then say that even iman, you cannot expect to be thanked. So that is something that we can talk about it. But about Islam, what have you done? Just saying Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah is not something important. If it comes with a strong conviction in the heart, that's important. But just saying Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, it's not something important. Many people said Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah just in order to be recognized as a Muslim. As we have in some of the du'as, إِنَّ قَوْمًا آمَنُوا بِأَلْسَنَتِهِمْ لِيَحْغَنُوا بِهِ دِمَاءَهُمْ. Just they wanted to protect themselves, just they wanted to, I don't know, benefit from the merits of Islam so that they can marry Muslims, or if they want to sell meat, people buy from them because they are Muslims. So this is something that would permit people to recognize you as a Muslim. But this is not something very important, very high level. Iman is important. So, يَمُنُّونَ عَلَيْكَ أَنْ أَسْلَمُوا قُلْ لَا تَمُنُّوا عَلَيَّ إِسْلَامَكُمْ. Don't ask me to show my gratitude and, you know, high appreciation of this. بَلِ اللَّهِ يَمُنُّ عَلَيْكُمْ أَنْ هَدَاكُمْ لِلْإِيمَانِ أَنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. If you are mu'min, that is something important. But Islam, no. Then we come to iman. Suppose you have iman. Again, who has to be thanked? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has to be thanked. So, if you don't have iman, there is nothing to appreciate. If you have iman, we appreciate that, but who is to be thanked? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, you see, there are different problems. بَلِ اللَّهِ يَمُنُّ عَلَيْكُمْ أَنْ هَدَاكُمْ لِلْإِيمَانِ. It is Allah who has obliged you by guiding you for iman, but إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. If you have iman, if you are truthful in your claim. If you don't have iman, there is nothing important. You are still not in a level that you are supposed to be. It's very low level, very superficial. If you have iman, that is great. But for this, we have to thank Allah, not to thank you. بَلِ اللَّهِ يَمُنُّ عَلَيْكُمْ أَنْ هَدَاكُمْ لِلْإِيمَانِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. So every mu'min, every person who is on the right path, every person who is doing good things, every person who has good characteristics, must thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Unfortunately, sometimes, you know, as soon as we do a little good things, we think that we are very important, we are very special. Allah has to thank me. Imam Zaman has to thank me because I have done these things. If you really have done anything good, you have to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving you this guidance, this opportunity. Yes, Allah himself also would thank, would appreciate. أُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ سَعْيُهُمْ مَشْكُورًا. But you must not expect Allah to thank you. He is going to thank, he is going to reward, he is going to praise you. Sometimes even Allah is so much happy that he says to his angels, look at my servant, what he is doing. But you must not expect this. If I do something good for you, I must not expect you to thank me. But at the same time, you are supposed to thank. These are two separate things. I should do it for the sake of Allah. La nuridu minkum jaza'an wala shukura. But the other party is also to thank. We don't need to teach Allah what to do. He knows how to appreciate, how to thank, how to reward, how to praise. He is not only shakir, he is shakur. He is very grateful. But you should not expect this. Whatever we do is all because of his favor and because of his support and guidance. بل الله يمن عليكم أن هداكم للإيمان إن كنتم صادقين إن الله يعلم غيب السماوات والأرض. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the unknown, whatever is hidden, whether it is in the skies and the earth. Of course, for him there is nothing like hidden, nothing like ghaib and shahada. This contrast is for us. For him everything is present, everything is known. This definition, this classification of ghaib and shahud, something which is hidden and something which is not hidden, it's only for us because our knowledge is limited. He knows everything, including what is in your heart. If there is iman, he knows. You don't need to teach him. He knows that there is iman. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ غَيْبَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Look what beautiful combination is here. وَاللَّهُ بَصِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. He also sees what you do, what you are doing. So iman, because it's not possible to be seen, he says يَعْلَمُ غَيْبَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. But actions can be seen. He says وَاللَّهُ بَصِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Is it clear? So something like iman, like nifaq, like kufr, these are qualities of the heart, and these are included under ghaib. These are hidden. He knows them. The actions, he sees. Yes, even in every action there is something hidden, and that is the intention. Again, that is ghaib. And Allah knows that. So he sees your action, but he knows the intention also, because he knows ghaib. So there is nothing hidden from him, whether it is something physical that you can see by your eyes, or whether it is something which is hidden in the heart. He knows everything. So far we have two different senses in which the term Islam is used. One, the highest level of iman. Even every mu'min is not able to claim that I am Muslim. Another is the lowest. Then there is a third sense. And that is the path. This is my understanding. The path from the first level to the highest level. That is also called Islam. As a religion, as a deen. So we have three senses. The lowest level, the highest level, and the direction that takes you from the first to the last. That is also Islam. For example, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, اليوم يئس الذين كفروا من دينكم فلا تخشوهم واخشون. Today, those who have no faith, the infidels, are despaired. They have no hope of harming, destroying, defeating your religion. They cannot do any harm to Islam. فلا تخشوهم. You should not have any worry about future of Islam. If you have right leadership, because this was said on the day of Ghadir, Islam with appropriate leadership cannot be defeated by any external factor. Wakhshaun, but fear me, means fear that you may do something that then I will take away this gift from you. So we should be worried about internal problems. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, today I have, after al-yawm akmaltu lakum dinakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati, says, wa radhitu lakum al-islama dina. I have perfected your religion, I have completed my blessings upon you, and I am happy and pleased with Islam as your religion, as your path. Deen means a way for life, a path, a journey. رَزِيْتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينَ. So Islam here is different from Islam of Ibrahim and Islam of the Bedouins. Islam here is the path to start as Bedouins started and reach the level of Ibrahim. Religion of Islam is the religion that teaches us how to submit ourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then achieve internal peace and external peace, worldly peace and peace in the heaven. So this is different ways in which Islam has been used in the Quran. And you have other verses, inna ad-din indallah al-islam. Again, Islam is used in the third sense. So one of these three are the meanings of Islam. As far as I know, I have come across these three different meanings. Just to start with shahadatain, the first level, to totally submit yourself to God, which is the highest level, and the way for reaching from this basic level to the highest level. And now you would not be surprised if I repeat the claim that we made several times in this series, that this path which leads to submission to God was the path of all the prophets, especially from the prophet Ibrahim ala nabiyyina wa alihi wa salam onwards. Of course, as we said before, even before Ibrahim alayhi salam, all the prophets called for this. But the one who was able to establish it, to articulate it, to show in his life perfect example of submission to God was Ibrahim alayhi salam. So he paved the way for tawheed, for submission to God. Salam alaykum. And it is through Ibrahim and the progeny of Ibrahim, whether they are the prophets of Bani Israel or the prophet of Islam and Imams, that humanity today knows about Tawheed. So this path of submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this path of not only believing in Tawheed, but also exhibiting Tawheed in every aspect of your life. Because sometimes we think Tawheed is just something that you say in the class of Aqaid, or when you are asked in the grave, you know, who is your Lord? You say, my Lord is one God. No, Tawheed is something that we have to show in our personal life, family life, in our legal system, in our economics, finance, family, everything must be according to Tawheed. This is the path of Ibrahim. And the plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was that every prophet teaches again this path, reminds people of this path, and asks people to submit themselves to this path, which is the path of God. But unfortunately, people were deviated. Some people, they said, for us, more important than this path is who is teaching us this. They became Yahudi, they became Nasrani. No access to the truth, no access to heaven, unless you belong to our own group. Of course, not everyone, but those who said this, which Allah says, قَالُوا كُونُوا هُودًا أَوْ نَصَارَى تَحْتَدُوا. Otherwise, there is no chance. So that, unfortunately, was a problem. That was a deviation. That was to sacrifice the core of the message of Ibrahim for the secondary issues. And I think today we have to restore the message of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Today we have to call people to go back to the religion of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Today the starting point for us Muslims, Jews and Christians is to follow Ibrahim by submitting ourselves to God. That is the main issue. After that we can discuss who has better understanding of God, who has better understanding of the will of God, of the commands of God. But the first thing is to submit ourselves to God. And I think people in different faith communities should find like-minded people. People who might be Jews or Christians or Muslims, Sunni, Shia, Catholic, Protestant, Orthodox, whatever, Reformed Jews, Orthodox Jews, if they have submission to God, then we can be together. We can be acting as a team. And we can, inside ourselves, talk about details, about differences, but we should form a community of faithful, a community of believers in God, a community of followers of Ibrahim, and invite the rest of humanity to this path. I think this has lots of implications for our scholars, for our ulama, for our muballighin to reflect on, and if they agree, I think we need to develop strategies based on this. We pray, inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the insight and the wisdom to understand His message properly, especially to understand how to apply His message to the world today. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hasten the reappearance of Imam Zaman, ajjal Allah ta'ala farajahu sharif. May Allah make him pleased with us. May Allah answer his du'as. May Allah give shifa to all the brothers and sisters who are ill and all people who are ill. May Allah send His unlimited rahmah to all the people who have passed away, especially those who have rights upon us, our ulama, our maraji, our martyrs. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the last moment of our life the best moment of our life. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillah rabbil alameen.